Although you may not have to show up to a closing, you should.
Let's wholesale real estate. We're gonna wholesale real estate. If you wanna wholesale real estate, then you are in the right place. You don't need no money, you don't need no credit. It's so simple that anyone can get it. Luke's gonna teach you just how to get started. All you have to do is learn and apply it. You are in the right place. You're gonna wholesale real estate. You're gonna wholesale real estate. So let's
What's going on, guys? Sock Passe, not Boulay, and welcome to another episode of School of Wholesaling. On this show, we talk about everything wholesaling, and I am your host, Luke Madeus. All right, guys, I want to talk to you guys about closings. My students and some of the folks that I've spoken with on the phone have asked me a specific question that I noticed have come up quite often, actually. And it's whether or not you should show up to a closing. All right. Whether or not you should show up to a closing. Before I get into that, though, guys, I just want to say this. I want to say this right now. I am having a meetup here in Orlando, Florida, January 7th at 4 o'clock. And we're going to be having wine and we're going to be talking about real estate. If you want to be a part of that, if you want to see me live, guys, talk about real estate, and if you have questions you want to ask that you'd like to share with me and pick my brain and also build a network here, all right, guys, feel free to join this meetup, guys. You can find it on meetup.com. It's Wine Tasting for Real Estate. Also, you can send me a DM, and I will send you the link to the meetup personally, all right? So don't be afraid to send me a DM, guys, and jump on board and be a part of the meetup, guys. It's going to be so much fun. So the other thing I want to say too, if you are new to this show and you haven't done so yet, download the free course of schoolofwholesaling.com. This free course is going to teach you the step-by-step process of a wholesale deal from start to finish, and it is going to show you exactly how to do a wholesale deal. All right, guys. So download that course if you haven't already at schoolofwholesaling.com. I'm not going to keep rambling on. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, start talking about what I want to tell you today. I got a nugget for you guys. All right. Should you show up to closings? Should you? The answer is you do not have to. You don't have to show up to closings because you don't have to sign anything. You're not buying any property. As a wholesaler, you do not have to sign off on any documents except for a purchase agreement and an assignment agreement. Everything else at closing is done between the buyer and the seller. So the seller and the buyer are the only two people that need to show up for a closing. Now, I want to touch on that really quickly. I want to give you guys a word of advice, all right? Whatever you do, do not let your buyer and seller close at the same time, all right? They should not be in the same room closing with each other. For obvious reasons, they've never met, okay? The buyer has no idea who your seller is. The seller has no idea who your buyer is. The last thing you want is them two talking at the table with all the numbers in front of them, talking about your assignment fee, okay? So when you are setting up closing times for closing and dates for closing, set your buyer and seller at different times during the closing day. You could set your buyer up for the morning and your seller for the afternoon, or vice versa, or you can set them a couple hours apart. The thing that matters is that they're not in the same room when they close, okay? That they're not closing at the same time, all right? So the other thing I wanna mention too, guys, although you may not have to show up to a closing, you should. I go to every one of my closings, guys, and I want to tell you the reason why. Huge gold nugget. When I go to my closings, the reason why I am there is to comfort my seller, okay? I like to give my sellers a really great experience from start to finish, and the deal isn't done yet until they sign off on closing documents. So I'm there to give them support, all right? Aside from that, I am also there to collect a testimonial. Every one of my sellers, every one of the deals I do, guys, I collect a testimonials from the seller. And I take that testimonial and I put it on our website. And I also put it on our YouTube page, okay? The reason why I do this, all right, guys, is because when your clients see that other people talk very good about you, they feel even more comfortable to do business with you. And I'm going to tell you this too. It's the 21st century. And with everything that's going on, many people are skeptical doing business with people they don't know, Okay? So when you have testimonials, when you have reviews on a Google page that you can show someone to show them and they can see, oh wow, other people have also done business with this person and they enjoyed it, guys, man, it makes you that much better in the eyes of all of your clients, and it will get you deals, okay? I've gotten deals before where I've been picked simply because I have other people who talk highly of our company. Okay, guys? So don't take this with a grain of salt. You don't have to go to your closings, but I suggest you do. Okay? So that's pretty much it for today's show, guys. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. I'm not gonna, draw it out for you guys or anything like that. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet and to the point. You don't gotta go to your closings, but you should. Collect a testimonial, all right? A video testimonial that you can put up on your website, or a video testimonial that you could put up on your Facebook page, anywhere you like, okay? And also collect a review that you can put on your Google review, so when people look up your company, they can see that other people have good things to say about you, and they could feel that much more comfortable doing business with you. And remember, at the closing, buyer and seller, they don't see each other when closing happens, all right? Other than that, guys, you guys get out there. You guys crush it. You guys be great. Remember, if you haven't done so already, book a call with me right now. It's a free call, guys. We can talk for 30 minutes about anything you want, all right? But I want to help you get your wholesaling business started, and I want to help you get your wholesale business running at 1,000 miles per second and give you the tools and the systems and the methods that I have, all right, to give you as much of an advantage as possible to get you your first deal as quickly as possible. All right, guys, so that's it for today's show. Again, if you want to join January 7th at 4 o'clock, if you want to join my meetup, guys, if you want to see me in person, simply reach out to me, send me a DM, and I will send you the link. It's on Meetup, okay? Look up School of Wholesaling on Meetup.com here in Orlando, Florida, and look up Wine Tasting for Real Estate, and you'll find it. All right, guys? So that's it for today's show. You guys be awesome. You guys are champions, and let's wholesale real estate. Peace.